Today we're going to be setting up the Christmas tree here in a computer room. I have this tree here, which is the Worst Choice Products Christmas tree. I don't know anything about the specifications. I got this particular one because it was very narrow, and that was the need at the time. I'm pretty sure I bought this last year. No, I didn't buy it last year. I bought it. I had it at the old location. So this might be year three on this one. It's not pre-lit, so there's really nothing that should go wrong. Other than the branches shedding excessively or something like that. This is a pretty nice tree. It's got pine cones on it and so forth. Some berries. It's a 7.5 foot. Okay, the stand is together. This one certainly is not the most realistic thing out there, but it's still pretty nice. And for those of you that are getting tired of these Christmas videos, which may not be too many, they've been getting pretty good ratings. This will probably be the last major Christmas setup video that I'll do. There'll be little things I do here and there over the next week or so. So this will be pretty much it. Did a lot more than I did last year. Didn't have much at all last year, relatively speaking. So this tree will get some kind of mini lights. don't really have a lot of electricity left in here because both circuits, because of a weird way this is set up, both circuits in here already have a set of outside lights on them, which is about 8 or 9 amps. So you're already getting close to the maximum theoretical allowed power draw. So we can't do anything in here that's like C9 or C7. So I've got a box here, right there, which has a bunch of mini lights in it. Many of them are old, so we'll pick something from there. I might use those stupid Kodak lights on here, perhaps. I think last year I did two strings of C9 clear white, which was a bit blinding. I don't like the way this top is designed. It gets kind of shabby. The whole thing looks so full. And then you get to the top here and it changes the way the branches are. It just doesn't look as nice. But this was a pretty inexpensive tree, so there's not too much complaining to be done. It's pretty good for what I paid. Okay, that tree is set up. That's nice. Move it back. Actually, we'll put the lights on first. So let's take a look at what options we have. So we have just plain old Mimi lights colored. These I think I put in the living room with those interesting silicone flame ones. Got some more white lights. Those are too short. Colored lights. This is a very, very early string of LED lights. This dates back to 2006, 2007, somewhere in that range. I have these lights. And I have more just colored mini lights. And then these are some novelty Hershey lights. These aren't the M&M ones. That's what this is. I have the M&M ones somewhere as well. I haven't covered those yet this year. I wonder where those are at. I thought both were in this bag when I looked last time, but that was definitely incorrect. That's not good. I have to try to figure out where those are. I like those. Yeah, definitely not in here. That's really odd. That is really odd. Okay then. So I think I'm going to use this string. This is an old, kind of ornate string. It's colored. It's pretty fancy. This dates back probably to the 80s. Let's see if it's going to work. I think this has been a pretty reliable string, but at this point I don't really remember. It's working. Alright, so I think we'll use this string. It's not going to be super bright, but it doesn't have to. Maybe what I'll do, because I've been wanting to use some bubble lights somewhere as well. Since those strings are pretty short, they don't draw too much power. Maybe I'll put these along with some bubble lights. I think I have several new in box strings of bubble lights somewhere downstairs. this is going to be well below the quantity of lights that I usually apply, but we have to work within certain constraints here. And another note in regards to those constraints, I have ordered a box of True Tone lights to try, and they should be coming today. At least providing the USPS does not screw up again. Thought I was going to be a little bit too long, but we're too short. Need quite a bit more. Cheese. Let's just see how that looks. I'm not even sure I'm going to like it. Actually, it looks pretty good, but we do need to extend the spring up more. It needs to go to the top for sure. We'll try to space it out a little bit better. So I'll try to pull the lights into the tree a little bit more, which will decrease the circumference they have to go through and give us more length to work with. Gosh, I'm getting dizzy doing this. This is ridiculous. I will make it this time. That's crooked. Yeah, I should have put a... I think I have stars somewhere. I know I have stars somewhere. I just haven't a clue where. See, these are the things I'm going to dig through over the next couple of weeks. And add as little extras as we go. All right, that's all set. I'm going to push this back to the wall. There's our tree for in here. Oh, it's 100% line, but I'll play with that later and get it corrected. That looks pretty good. Now we're gonna move on to some fiber optic trees. I discovered these a couple of years ago and I just really took a liking to them. This is a 32-inch unit. I have one that's slightly taller as well. We'll put this one in here. Itself already. That was a little concerning. I believe I replaced the bulb with an LED bulb. It would have originally been a halogen bulb, but it went out. I think I replaced it with DEL. So this should not have a significant power draw. This only claims to take in 17 watts, even with the old halogen bulb. So it should be fine. I will have to put a larger power bar under this desk, because this one is only a 4 outlet and it's already full, and there's nowhere to plug this in.
Two.
I must see $2 for it, maybe. What a steal. Alright, so that's on. That's working. Turn this off so you can see it better. Very nice. Okay. Now I'll put some lights around the window. And I think what I will do here is I have another string of lights that is old. This is a loop style set. I have three of these. I don't know where the other two are. Let's see if this one works. At least these are pretty easy to fix. And it's not working. Alright, not good. It's not working. Sometimes if this doesn't fix it, you'll at least see like a spark occurring where the bad bulb is. I'm not seeing anything here. Oh, I am. This one's sparking, so I bet this is the bad one. I think it was the... Yep, the ends just broke right off. This is probably the issue. This string has a lot of the original bulbs still, and they're just starting to deteriorate. These strings are very, very old. Yep, it was this one. So I just need to get a new bulb. Sometimes there's bulbs in here. Oh yeah, look at that. And of course the question becomes, what milliamps are they, all this stuff. This, I believe, is a standard string of 50, so shouldn't have any crazy requirements. These newer bulbs don't fit very well in these sockets. They're slightly bigger. And it just burned right out. So who knows? Well, I was going to change out the other one, but I guess there's no point. Because these are not the right size. Well, this is working for now, and I can go ahead and replace the bulbs later because this is not an unreachable outdoor install. So we'll loop these around the window. We'll see if I get it to fit well. If it fits well, these are great for applications like this, but sometimes it doesn't fit that well. So what it is one wire that goes around and creates a loop. That's how they used to be. That's kind of weird. Can you see that at the bottom on the floor there? That bulb was flashing. No, I think it's going out. It's back. But the rest of the string's not going with it, which is kind of unusual. Alright, so this is going to be a bit long. Perhaps you can even get around this twice. These are spaced pretty far apart, so going around twice would actually be kind of ideal.
And many of these are the original bulbs still. They have much nicer coloring to them than the ones that they make today. Much nicer coloring. I'm going to take that picture for a minute. This is in the way. Cool, it's lining up just about perfectly. Grandfather used to use a couple strings like this many years ago. Those are probably at his house somewhere still. All right, there we go. That looks good. Bring this back in the freak show. These vintage lights on the window. Vintage lights on the tree. Lastly, I think we'll just put some mini lights around the doors. Maybe a string of 100, and then a string of 50 to do it. I have should have that. Well, these look like both hundreds, though. Well, let's see what we get. Maybe 200s will work. I think that might be a little bit too much. An old string of 100 used to be like 40, 50 something feet. These are maybe 20, if that, 15 or 20. Because the spacing is so close. It's a decent lead to them, at least. Although, of course, in this case, you don't really want that. I'm going to start on this side because if it's too long, we can fudge it under the tree or something. Oh. The heck? It's a twinkling string. Well, I guess that's kind of cool. That's not what I was expecting, but...
Okay. A twinkling string. Interesting.
Okay. I guess you might as well use the novelty strings, adds a little bit of interest. Just tack this down over here so it stays at the bottom. I do go in this closet quite often, so I want to make sure that the lights are not going to get in the way of the door and it'll break.
Okay, I think that's going to be it. Got the vintage whites on the window, and we've got the twinkling lights on the wall. We got the vintage whites on the tree, regular lights on the wall, and then the fiber optic tree.